来向我们的上帝表示啊、表示感谢，要表达他们的爱。
So if you see in your hands,
所以在你手中
，you have this small booklet，
我们有一个小册子
，and there are three songs inside。
然后里面有打印它的那个歌词。
So we'd like to invite everyone to remain standing。
所以我们要邀请大家继续的站立。
Let us sing this song and express our thanksgiving to God。
来，让我们一起唱这几首歌。
See you. For many, the wedding ceremony itself is the height, the climax of your relationship.
很多时候，对一些人来说呢，婚礼就是他们两个人的关系中的最高潮。
We feel that at this point, it is when we are most deeply in love.
他们觉得在这个时刻就是两个人最相爱的时刻。
I'm sure for the wedding day itself, a lot of plans, a lot of planning, a lot of time, a lot of effort, a lot of money has been spent.
我相信呢，为了筹备这个婚礼，真的要花很多的心思，还有很多的计划，很多的金钱。
And the desire is to make everything perfect so that they can celebrate their love for one another.
新人们总是非常的渴望，一切都是美好，一切都是完美的，能够来庆祝他们的婚礼。
And for many,After the wedding ceremony, their relationship goes downhill.
而对一些人来说呢，从婚礼了之后呢，他们的关系却是走下坡。
But I have a different perspective.
但是呢，我有不同的看法。
Relation, marriage is the joining together of two individuals.
结婚呢是两个人的结合。
It is not the end, it is a new beginning.
它不是一个结束，它是一个新的开始。
And with God's help,
借着神的帮助
the marriage will become better and stronger.
这个婚姻呢会越来越刚强
And together, they will experience new depths of love and new heights of joy.
他们肯定能够经历最高潮的爱和喜乐在婚姻中
Because two is better than one.
因为两个人比一个人好
So very quickly, I want to give you five P's that will help you establish peace in your home.
很快的，我要让大家来看五个原则，怎么样在
And from the Bible perspective, peace is not just don't fight.
从圣经的观点来看，平安并不是代表说不吵架、打架。
Peace is wholesome.
这个平安呢是完
So that you can experience everything good that comes from God. That all will go well with you. So the first C is to be pragmatic, to be realistic. To believe and understand that no one is perfect.
故事呢，就是代表了解到没有人是完美的。
Perhaps I might be wrong.
可能我错了。
I just want to quickly check. Any one of you think you are perfect?
我想问看我们当中有没有人觉得他自己是完美的呢？可以举手一下。
Very perfect.
非常的完美的有吗？
Almost perfect, but not perfect yet.
接近完美还没有到完美的，有这样的人吗？
And what it means is that we are imperfect, and so we will make mistakes in our lives.
那就是代表呢，既然我们都不完美呢，在我们的生命当中一定会有做错事情的时候。
Jonathan and Dylan looked so perfect today.
Jonathan and Dylan 今天看得非常的完美的漂亮哦。As
perfect as we are, we will still make mistakes.
就算我们很想成为很完美，可是我们还是会犯错误。And
so because of this, I want to encourage you to have 3 rooms in your relationship.
所以我要鼓励你呢，在你的关系当中一定要有三个房间。Number
1.
第一,
is the room to let the other person make mistakes.
有一个空间能够让对方做错事情。
Number 2.
第二,
what is very important is to be proactive.
第二是积极。
And when we have a problem,
那我们有面对一项困难,
definitely there will be conflicts, there will be misunderstanding,
会有冲突, 会有误解,
differences of perspective,
有不同的看法。
When that happens, how should our attitude be?
当这件事发生的时候，我们的态度应该是怎样的呢？Do we say why did you do this？我们是不是跟对方说你为什么这样做？
It's all your fault.
都是你的错。
Or would you ask yourself？
还是你会问问自己？What
did I do to contribute to this problem？
我到底做了什么事情造成这件事的发生？What
can I do to solve this problem？
我能够做些什么来解决这个问题？
You see, a lot of times we think in terms of rights.
很多时候我们都想到我们的权利。
I'm a husband.
我是做丈夫的。
This is my right.
这是我的做丈夫的权利。
This is what you should do for me.
你应该为我做这些事情。
I'm the wife.
我是太太。
These are my rights.
这也是我做妻子的权利。
These are what you should do for me.
这些就是你应该为我做的。
And so how we approach marriage when we base it on rights?
如果我们在建立在这个权利方面是怎样建立一个婚姻呢？
Is that we are always asking the other person.
我们就会一直地追问对方。
Or we are always telling the other person.
我们总是告诉对方。
This is what you are supposed to do for me.
我们一直跟对方说，这是你要为我做的。
You owe me.
你欠我。
The wife say you owe me.
太太对丈夫说，你欠我。
The husband say you owe me.
丈夫又对太太说，你欠我这么多。
So this becomes a debt collector's marriage.
这就变成一个好像大耳窿的那个关系了。
How many of you like to be pursued by debt collectors?
你们有多少人喜欢被大耳窿追杀呢？
Of course, none of us.
我相信没有人喜欢。
None of us like that.
我们不喜欢这样。
And we would be happy.
我们也不会开心。
Let's look at another perspective.
让我们从另一个观念来看。
Where each of us take up the responsibility.
就是我们两个人都拿起这个责任。
This is my role.
这是我的。 角色,
this is what I'm supposed to do for you.
我应该为你做的。
I want to do this for you.
我想要为你做这些事。
I give you.
我把这些给你。
The husband says to the wife, I give you.
丈夫对太太说，这是我给你的。
And the wife says, yeah.
然后太太说，哦，太好了。
Then the wife says to the husband, I give you.
那么太太也对丈夫说，这些是我给你的。
The husband says, yeah.
哇，太棒了，好。
So do we want to emphasize on rights or responsibilities?
我们的婚姻应该是放在这个权利呢，还是在责任呢？
So let us fulfill our responsibilities in marriage.
所以，那我们在婚姻当中来实现我们的责任。
Number 3.
第三。
We need to be positive.
我们需要非常的积极。
If we get a piece of paper.
如果有一张白纸。
And then on the piece of paper, there's just one black dot.
出现的一个黑点。
Where is our focus on?
到我们的焦点应该放在哪里。
We look at that black dot.
我们就很自然呢，就会看着白纸上的黑点。
Even though the black dot is only 0.001% of the entire piece of paper.
可能呢，它是整纸的0.01%。
And in the same way, in our relationship with one another,
同样的两个人之间的关系
we over focus on the black dots of our relationship.
我们是不是在关系当中太过注重这个小小的黑点呢？
And we forget to celebrate the other 99.999% of the relationship.
那我们就会让我们忘记了去好好的庆祝，我们还有99.99999% 美好的事情。
So I want to encourage the couple today.
所以要鼓励今天的新人。
Be positive.
一定要积极。
Instead of focusing on the weaknesses, the negatives of the relationship.
我们不要一直专注在两个人中间软弱的地方。
Let us focus on what is positive.
让我们把焦点放在非常积极好的那一
方。Let us focus on what is encouraging.
我们放焦点在非常鼓励的。
Let us focus on what is beneficial.
就是放焦点在带来彼此好处的。
Number four.
第四点。
Be patient.
充满耐心。
Yes, we know what to do.
是的，我们已经懂得要怎么做。
We know how to do.
我们也懂得怎样做。
That doesn't mean we can do it well immediately.
但并不代表我马上就可以做得很好。
Because change takes time.
因为改变是需要时间。
You know this very famous scripture in the New Testament.
在圣经新约圣经中有这样的一句话。
First Corinthians chapter. 13 verses 4 to 8.
就在哥林多前书第十三章第十八节。
It tells us how we should love one another.
告诉我们应该怎样的彼此相爱。
It has 8 positive and 8 negative.
有八个积极的，有八个消极的。
But do you know what is number one?
你知道爱是什么吗？
What is the number one character of love?
对爱的第一个特点是什么？
Love is patient.
爱是恒久忍耐。
And so if you are patient, if you want to love one another,
如果你有那耐心，你彼此相爱，
you must have patience.
你一定要有耐心。
Because change takes time.
因为改变是需要时间的。
Number five.
第五点。
Be prayerful.
要常常祷告。
Because God can help you.
神可以帮助我们。
In all your troubles, turn to Him. Seek Him.
在我们所有的困难当中，都可以向神求救。
So there are five things.
五样事情。
I want to close with a story.
我要说一个故事来结束。
One day there was a couple.
有一天有一对夫妻。
The wife was sitting at the in front of TV watching a movie.
那么太太就坐在电视面前看套电影。
It was a love story.
是一个爱情故事。
And so as she was watching the movie, she was deeply moved. And she felt very romantic.
她看着这个爱情的电影呢，她心中感到非常的罗曼蒂克，也被感动。
And then she told her husband.
就告诉先生。
Darling.
亲爱的。
Can you please come and sit beside?
你好不好？这个时候坐在我的身边。
And so the husband quickly put down what he was doing and went and sat beside the wife.
丈夫就赶快把手中的东西放下，赶快坐到太太的身边。
Moving together.
然后他们就一起的看这套电影。
Then she said, Darling, can you please put your arms around me?
那么她就对丈夫说。
Can you please put your arms around me?
你可以不可以把你的手放在我身上？
And so the husband put the arms around her.
然后丈夫呢就把手抱着太太的。
And the wife put her head on his shoulder.
然后太太就把头靠在丈夫的肩膀上。
And then they were having this very romantic time.
他们有一个非常罗曼蒂克的时刻。
And the wife said to the husband.
太太对丈夫说。
Darling, can you please nibble on my ear?
亲爱的，你可以不可以闻一闻我的耳垂？
And suddenly the husband stood up.
突然间，丈夫站了起来。
And then the husband rushed to the toilet.
他赶快跑到洗手间。
And the wife was looking at him. What's wrong? What did I say wrong?
太太很惊讶，哎，丈夫跑去哪里哦？
And then the husband quickly go to the toilet and came out.
那么丈夫从厕所冲了出来。
And the wife was still looking at the husband. Why, darling?
那么太太很好奇，在看着先生到底发生什么事情。
And then the husband said, I'm so sorry, I will go to the toilet and pick up my dentures.
对不起，我先戴上我的假牙。
Because they've been married for so long.
因为他们结婚好久一段时间。
From young until old.
从年轻到年老。
And they're still deeply in love with each other.
但是呢，还是彼此深深地爱着对方。
And I pray the same will happen to you.
我祷告在你们身上也是同样的。
And apply these 5 P's in your marriage.
而且能够把这5个原则应用在你们的婚姻当中。
So that you will experience peace.
好让你们的婚姻能够进入平安。
God bless you.
神祝福你。
God, and in the presence of all these wonderful witnesses who join together, Jonathan and Tingwen, in holy Christian matrimony. Now may I ask who gives Tingwen to be married to Jonathan? Yes, let's give our brother Alan a round of applause. Please be seated. He's the bride's father. Jonathan and Tingwen, as you both stand in the presence of God, before whom the secrets of all hearts are disclosed, I request you both to pledge before God this faith for each other. Be well assured that if in obedience to God's word, that these solemn vows are kept inviolate, and if steadfastly you keep the will of your Heavenly Father, God will bless and enrich your marriage, and He will grant you fulfillment and establish your home in peace. Sorry, you probably look, you see some delay because the light is so bright tonight. Cannot see so clearly. Okay, never mind. The important thing is this couple right in front. So Jonathan, do you take Tingwen to be your wedded wife? And do you solemnly promise before God and these witnesses that you will love her, comfort her, honor and keep her in sickness and in health, and that forsaking all others for her alone, you perform unto her all the duties that a husband owes to his wife until God by death shall separate you?
I do.
Let's give Jonathan a round of applause. I noticed that when you are coming towards the last part, just before I popped the question of whether for his response, he looks to the left, look at Tingwen, take a glance from top to bottom, bottom to the top, with a smile that is so sweet, and then he says, I do. Let's give him a round of applause. Tingwen, do you take Jonathan to be a wedded husband? And do you solemnly promise before God and these witnesses that you will love him, comfort him, honor and keep him in sickness and in health, and that forsaking all others for him alone, you perform unto him all the duties that a wife owes to her husband until God by death shall separate you?
Yes, I do.
I was a bit concerned when she started out with Surely, they are deeply in love with each other. Since it's your desire to take each other as husband and wife, please join your right hands. Join your right hands, yeah. And Jonathan, please repeat after me this vow. Tingwen, today before God.
Tingwen, today before God.
And all my relatives and friends.
And all my relatives and friends.
I take you to be my wife.
I take you to be my wife.
I give myself to you.
I give myself to you.
As a loving.
As a loving.
Faithful.
Faithful.
And God-fearing husband.
And God-fearing husband.
By God's grace.
By God's grace.
I will take full responsibility.
I will take full responsibility.
For you.
For you.
Materially.
Materially.
Emotionally.
Emotionally.
And spiritually.
And spiritually.
You are the most important person in my life.
You are the most important person in my life.
Besides the Lord Jesus Christ.
Besides the Lord Jesus Christ.
In the days to come.
In the days to come.
I will wholeheartedly rely on the guidance of the Holy Spirit.
Rely on the guidance of the Holy Spirit.
So that the life of Christ.
The life of Christ.
May be evident.
May be evident
in our marriage.
In our marriage.
Let's give Jonathan a round of applause. And now we have Ting Wen to recite the marriage vow. And for that, I need my wife. That is why two is better than one.
Jonathan.
Jonathan.
今天与上帝和众亲友面前，
与上帝和众亲友面前，
我以身许你，
我以身许你，
以你为我丈夫，
以你为我丈夫，
而且我将一切所有，
将一切所有，
一切所事，
将一切所事
给你，在我们
一起的生活中。
一起的生活中，
我要尽力
鼓励你，
安慰你，
好让你完成，鼓励你，
安慰你，
协助你，
好让你完成，
神在你身上
的托付。
Let's give Ting Wen a round of applause.
I give you this ring
as a token of my love.
Well, let's give him a big clap. And now we have Ting Wen to put the ring on for Jonathan.Would you say these words?
Jonathan, 我将此戒指给你，作为我爱的信物。
Let's give Ting Wen a round of applause. Grab long. And I witnessed the same before us and before God, and they too have given and pledged their faith to each other, and have declared the same.By the joining of their right hands, by the giving and receiving of rings, I declare as a minister of the gospel, according to the ordinance of God, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, that they are husband and wife. Brothers and sisters, friends and relatives, may I present to you Mr. and Mrs. Lau.Jonathan, you may now lift the veil and kiss the bride. Representation of God's love for us. This
圣餐是代表了神对我们的爱。
It represents Jesus' death on the cross. How his body was broken for us and how his blood was shed for us. And so, as a new beginning, as they come together as a couple, they want to establish their marriage on the foundation of God's love.By remembering Jesus' love for them.
来纪念神对他们的爱。
We will pray and then they'll proceed with the Holy Communion.
我们先祷告，然后来进行圣餐。
Heavenly Father, we thank you for your love.
天上的父，我们感谢你对我们的爱。
Your love that never ceases.
因为你的爱永不止息。
Your love that is always abounding, always growing.
你的爱呢，会让在我们里头继续的成长。
And God, I pray that as Jonathan and Ting Wen.Come together in holy matrimony.
Jonathan 和定文在他们的婚姻圣礼中。
And as they establish their home.
当他们从此之后建立了他们的家庭。
Lord, we pray that you show them how much you love them.
主啊，我也祷告你来向他们彰显你爱他们是如此多。
You are always with them.
你总是与他们同在。
Thank you, Jesus.
感谢耶稣。
In Jesus' name we pray.
耶稣名字祷告。
Amen. Amen.
hand
是基督徒的,
to identify with us in this action. Heavenly Father, we're so excited to see the joining together of Jonathan and Dingwen. We know how deeply they feel for each other. Lord, you are the one who brought them together.
主啊,你乃是您,是亲自地把他们结合在一起。
And we thank you that you promised to be with them from this day onwards.
我们也知道你应许从今天开始,你每一天,每时刻都与他们同在。
You're more than willing to guide them, to teach them.
你是那么的愿意来指引他们,来教导他们。
To provide the necessary resources for them.
你会供应一切他们所需要的资源。
So that they will continuously fall in love with each other.
好让他们继续的彼此的相爱。
And grow to be strong and mature believers.
并且呢,也成为非常刚强,非常成熟的信徒。
Then through their lives,
借着他们的生命,
their families will be blessed.
他们的家庭都会得到祝福。
Their colleagues will be blessed.
他们的同事得到祝福。
Their neighbors will be blessed.
他们的邻舍也得到祝福。
Thank you, Jesus.
感谢耶稣。
In Jesus' name we pray.
用耶稣的名字祷告。
Amen.
Amen.
Let's give them a round of applause.
我们用掌声来鼓励他们。
Congratulations.
恭喜。
To my parents, thank you for raising me and always taking care of me. Your support, guidance shaped who I am today. I am grateful that my life may not go as I planned, knowing that my family is home waiting for me. It gives me strength and feeling love. I wish you guys live long and healthy so that I can take care of you guys when I'm ready. To my three sisters, thank you for taking care of me. You guys make a great example, sister. When I was small, I never noticed how much my sister been taking care of me.
Sí. 合我的喜好。当我很懒惰要表达自己的时候，每次表达我的意愿都非常明白我想要的是什么。我也很开心地看着你越来越优秀，越来越成功，也越来越棒，继续赚多多的钱，疼我，还买多多东西给我。我就靠哥哥和老公养我了。还有谢谢爸爸和姐姐姐夫们，虽然我的福建话听不懂，讲也不会讲，可是谢谢你们的接纳和爱，让我融入了你们的家庭，也谢谢你们培养了一个很会做家务和干净整齐的儿子。谢谢爸妈从刚开始和我语言不通到后来越来越多交流，我看得出你们很努力在用华文英文来和我讲话，和永远也不会让我在你们那里饿着，永远都有打包好和会准备好食物给我们，谢谢你们。Hi Marbury, I think this was the first time to have a serious, formal and sweet thank you speech to you somewhere in front of so many people. So outward for an introvert person like me, but as a process, I have to do it long. 谢谢你这六年的爱 or else maybe a little that, 从我们是好朋友就开始给予的爱。谢谢你会欣赏我的优点，找到我的发光点，看见我的细腻细心，虽然我都一直很冷淡，偶尔也很凶，但你依然很照顾我，也是个很顾家的男人。谢谢你总会倾听我的所有意见，然后帮我解决处理，和你默默的改变付出，成为越来越棒也越来越有担当的男人。加油。
Everything is as I imagined, me standing here and you standing there. Felt like just yesterday when we were still in university. You were my best friend, became my girlfriend, and now who I proudly call my wife. Thank you for showing your love and care throughout the journey, and thank you for being my beacon of light when I am lost. Your presence showed me that the world does not only have to be black and white.Your beautiful shades of pink that you added into my life has given me feeling of love and warmth. Thank you for choosing me to be your partner of your life. Let us move to our next chapter with more colors in life. And I look forward to spend my life with you.